Good morning.
Good morning.
On the second Sunday of the Easter season, and we all know, that Easter is not a one-off thing. Our baptisms aren't one-off things. We die and rise every day, Luther says, and so Easter is a constant resurrection. So very thankful that you can join us today, and very thankful that Herb and Jim both are joining us as well, and it does our hearts good. And I'm very much aware that many of you are having procedures and medications and doctor's visits and tests and being injected and being probed in many ways. And so we are thankful that we can come here for the healing that we don't get billed for. Any announcements that people have to make? Carol first.
There is a sign-up sheet on the bulletin board for anyone who would like to donate food for Judy Stratton's service on April 20th.
Everybody hear that? On the bulletin board, right? Signing up for food for the meal after the celebration of life for Judy Stratton. Sue?
I think everybody probably noticed the buckets out in the hallway. That means April is bucket month. We collect cleaning supplies for the People's Resource Center. And that'll run all month. I think the last Sunday is the 28th.
Thank you. And I know the Men's Fellowship is meeting Thursday at 11:30, right? Everybody knows where that is? 11:30 Thursday at?
Honey Jam Cafe. Honey Jam Cafe.
Is that the thing that used to be Butterfield's?
Right.
That's what it used to be.
I noticed that. What is Honey Jam? Okay. All right. Let's rise and prepare our hearts for worship. Rise if you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter and our joy.
Amen.
Behold, here is water.
Here is our water of life. Alleluia.
Immersed in the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you were glorious under over the deep. Water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve held Eden's nourishing rivers. The ark carried the animals through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people, Israel, passed through the sea into freedom's land. In a wilderness cool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Behold, here is water. Here is our water of life. Alleluia. At the River Jordan, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you. Through the risen Christ, our source of the living water of divine love, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Behold, here is water. Here is our water of life.
Alleluia.
Thank you.
Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Almighty God, with joy we celebrate the day of our Lord's resurrection. By the grace of Christ among us, enable us to show the power of the resurrection in all that we say and do. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
A reading from Acts. Now the whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, but everything they owned was held in common. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have the advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. And he is atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sometimes we go different ways because we're reading an epistle all the way through, and it's not always in consonance with the Old Testament or the Gospel. But today they all work together. And if you have your bulletin, let's just take a quick look at these lessons for today. Because to me, they all speak of one thing. And in Hebrew, that one thing is called Yahad. That's used in the psalm for today. And Yahad is oneness. It's built on the word one. It's oneness or unity. And in Greek, it's koinonia, which is often translated fellowship. But it means the same, oneness, unity. So anyway, look at Acts. And you see it right in the beginning. Now the group of those who believed were one heart, one soul. There's that oneness. And they hold all their property in common. And the Greek word there is koinos, the same as the root of koinonia, having things in common. So they have an economic commonness and unity. And they have, verse 33, great power and great grace. And then there's not a needy person among them. And this is the newness that the resurrection brings into a believing community. And you can just imagine all the things that scatter us and divide us and tear us apart. Those things that run rampant in the world, here they're reversed for the believers, the resurrection community. And then Psalm 133, if you look at that. How good, how pleasant it is when kindred live together in unity. There's the Hebrew word, in the yahad, in the oneness. And then it has those peculiar things. It's like fine oil on the beard. I don't know if any of you have beards or you would be real happy if a lot of oil was dripping down off of your beard. But in the idioms in Hebrew, it was a good thing because oil was hard to come by. And you know, if you had oil in the dry desert-like conditions, you know, it would be great. And so this unity that we have is just an extravagance of goodness of life. And like verse 3, like the dew of Hermon, it's not Hermon here we're talking about, but a mountain up in the north of Israel where the waters come down, and it's the only source of water for the whole doggone country is the Jordan River, and it all comes down from Mount Hermon. It's like life itself to have unity. And then 1 John, in that reading from 1 John, there's four times they use the word koinonia. And here it's translated fellowship, fellowship, fellowship. And the whole reason we tell you about Jesus Christ and the whole reason of Easter is that we might have fellowship, that we might have oneness and unity. And then the gospel, he goes on to say if we have fellowship, we are in the light and we are not in the darkness. We'll come back to that a little later. And then the gospel of John, I know we all thrill to Thomas. But note that Jesus says, blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. In the early Christian community, there must have been a division between those who have seen and those who have not seen. And the Gospel of John is saying, let's all those who have seen and not seen, it doesn't matter, let's come together. And what Jesus does is give the Holy Spirit. And what does the Holy Spirit inspire you to do? To forgive sins, but also to retain sins. We'll get back to that in a little bit. But there's all this talk about unity, and there's a couple things that I just wanted to stress and home in on a little bit. And that is in the lesson from Acts, it says that they're full of grace. They got grace upon grace, it says, in places. And they're able to live without people being in need. Think about what that means. I had sort of I was looking at this passage this week, and I came in from doing the round with the dogs, exercising them, and talked to Connie, and she was putting on her shoes, which is not too easy these days. She's been having a lot of pain in her ankle, and some days it means it's almost impossible for her to walk. And I said to her, I said, well, don't worry about any of that, because I'll do all the walking of the dogs, house, and you know, I can prepare breakfast, and from time to time, not always maybe, but I can do some more of the chores. And she, Connie said, I hate that. Well, she hates it because she's a giver, and she's a doer, and she's someone who takes care of other people. She's somebody who solves problems. And I said to her, well, I know you hate it, but you have to receive graciously, and I have to give graciously. I think that word grace came into my vocabulary because of Acts, and this idea that there was nobody in need, and it was because the people who had more money graciously shared it. Not, they didn't grumble. They didn't think of excuses for not helping somebody else out, like, you lazy so-and-so, why can't you do for yourself? But the people who received also had to receive graciously. There's a lot of resentment in this world. A lot of resentment, I think, drives poisonous politics, I think. And resentment can come from people who give. They get donor fatigue, right? They hear all the stories about the welfare queens and sit around and do nothing. And why, you know, I work for mine, why can't you work for yours? And now that resentment builds up, right? And now they have immigrants coming in from other countries. And well, wait a minute, our roots are deep in America, and I'm an American, and you don't deserve any of this. But also, there is a, I think sometimes a bigger problem and more resentment that builds up when you have to receive. And all of us, I think, you know, we hate it. We hate it. If you're human, you hate being helped and having someone help you to do things that maybe you used to be able to do all by yourself. But the grace goes two ways, doesn't it? It helps us to get rid of that resentment when we give, but also the resentment when we have to receive. And I think that's part of the spirit that was working in the early church, and why, at least for many of them, and for a while, there was nobody that was needy at all, because they held all things in that koinonia, in that oneness. The other interesting little phrase in our lessons today is when Jesus breathes out the Holy Spirit upon the disciples, and he says, when you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. And we wish he would cut off right there. But then he goes on to say, but if you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Why is that important? What does that mean? And also connected to that, I think, is the 1 John lesson too, because in 1 John, it says, if you think you're walking in light and you're not, and if you say you don't have any sin and you do, then you've got a problem. Then it's hard for you to have fellowship. Years ago in the church, there were a couple of women who were close friends, and they both had two young children. One was Nancy and the other was Faye. And both of them had husbands who were gamblers. And they liked to take the bigger chunk of the family income and gambling with it. And every time they would lose a lot of money, the husbands would come home and say, well, I'm sorry. And I won't do that again. And the wives were of the habit of not causing a lot of turmoil in the family, keeping things together, but they would say, that's all right, it's okay, I forgive. And that went on over and over and over again. Until finally, of course, the husbands got such terrible debt, they hadn't paid income tax for years, and they just disappeared, leaving these two women to take care of the children and to take care of all that debt that had piled up. Now, what's wrong with that picture? The picture is that forgiveness is a wonderful thing, but along with it has to come the retention of sin at times, doesn't it? And what does that mean? It means that we have to tell people that you too live by virtue of the yahad, of the koinonia, of the unity, of the oneness, of the circle of being that God has created. You too depend on that. And if you don't take responsibility for it, if you're not held accountable, you're cheating yourselves, you're lying to yourselves, you, and you're lying to all of us as well, and it's all going to fall apart. So Jesus gives us the gift of being able to say to others, well, your sins are forgiven, but wait a minute, you're also accountable. You're also responsible for what's going on in our family or in our community. So, this week, we're reminded once again, the resurrection isn't a one-off thing that happened once and proves that Jesus is God, but the resurrection is that Christ is alive among us, and Christ is pouring out the Holy Spirit upon us. And we go away from this place, and we declare to one another, we witness to one another about what Jesus has done. But we do it for the sake of the yahad, of the oneness, of the koinonia, of the unity, of being responsible to one another and being able to be gracious enough to both give when there's need and to receive when we need. God grant it for Jesus' sake. profess our faith in the triune God in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe.
Believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the rest.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need of good news. We praise you, Lord God, and raise our alleluia. We thank you for the power of Christ's resurrection. You have made us resurrection people. Christ breathes on us your spirit so that we might be united in the universal fellowship of love. When we are in need, help us to accept help graciously so that we might be free of shame. When we see others in need, may we give help graciously, so that we might be free of resentment. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for the authority to forgive and retain sins. Help us show mercy to all, but also hold up one another accountable and responsible to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for the budding leaves and flowers, the songs of birds, and all the wonders of the cosmos, from the soil beneath our feet to the sun and stars overhead. You bless us and fill our lives with gifts of goodness and glory. May we treasure them, protect them, and share them compassionately. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for designing this world to be filled with peace and justice. We lament and repent of the way greed and fear have broken this vision. Fill us with the spiritual ambition and hope of the resurrection, so that we might keep watch, keep sharing, keep working to do your will on earth as it is done in heaven. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for your spirit of healing and health that is always at work among and within us. We entrust to you all our loved ones in special need of you, and we offer ourselves as agents of your healing. Prayers from the congregation are now welcome.
We give thanks to God for return of her to our worship and our fellowship, and Jim as well. And in our prayers, we put our arms around all the others of our congregation and all of our loved ones who are in need of you. And I pray, Lord, personally, that you would help Connie to keep on being as positive and as forthright in her own healing as she works to accept the advice of the surgeons and others. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, I give you thanks for the life of Marge, and I pray for her brother, Mervyn Mickey, who's in hospice right now in the heavens. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Remind us everything that God of grace.
Hear our prayer.
We thank you, O God, for Bob, for all the St. Luke choir, for Roberta, for Dick and Carol, and Joe and Marilyn and Fred, and all our pastors and all our good and gracious volunteers who make our worship and work and fellowship here at St. Luke rich in every way. We thank you for the lives of those who now rest in you, including our parents and grandparents, and including Dietrich Bonhoeffer, who resisted the hate and the racism of the Nazis and gave his life in faithfulness to the gospel. Give us such discernment to see how we can serve, and give us such courage to stand up against the evils around us. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share that peace with one another.
Fred?
Lord's peace to you.
Okay. Good to see you.
Yeah. Peace of the Lord be with you.
Peace be with you.
Nice to see you.
Yeah, back from Florida, a place exotic like that?
No. We stay in the Winter Center.
Oh, you do?
Okay. Yeah, just in the last couple of years.
We have hip surgery.
This winter. Both times.
Fun.
Nice to see you, Fred.
Lord's peace.
Oh, it didn't work.
No.
witnesses in the world through Jesus Christ, our true life.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God. For the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true paschal lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so, with Mary Magdalene and Peter, and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, us in the breaking of the bread, come and eat at God's table. Rise if you are able. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Shepherd of God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend.
Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope be with you all, bless you, and now and always.
Amen.
They're always good.
Yeah.